Hi, it's Carolyn with PlumbingSupply.com again, and today we're going to talk about how to measure for an escutcheon. If you don't know what an escutcheon is, you're not alone. Most people don't. It's a really funny word for a flange. These are the pretty little things that go around the outside of your pipes to cover up the hole in the wall so that everything looks all neat and clean. Now, you might be thinking, well, how do I know what size of pipe I have coming out of my wall? And really, it's pretty simple, you just have to measure it. But sometimes that can get a little bit tricky depending on what kind of pipe you have. Looking at these two escutcheons, you wouldn't probably realize that these are actually both for half-inch pipe. This one is for half-inch copper, and this one is for half-inch IPS. Obviously, you can tell that these are not going to fit over the same size pipe. So the most important thing is, first of all, to determine what kind of pipe you have, and then what size it is. 99% of the time, what's going to be used in your home is either going to be copper or galvanized stainless steel. Now, copper is pretty easy to tell, it's copper colored, and it's not usually threaded. Galvanized, again, it's not going to be copper colored, and it's going to be threaded. So generally, you're not going to have much of a problem. Most commonly, coming out of the stub out of your wall is going to be half-inch pipe, because most of the valves that are used, stop valves, angle valves, are half-inch valves. Inside your walls might be a different size, but usually coming out is going to be half-inch. But you can easily measure to make sure of that. Copper pipe is always going to be easiest, because all you have to do is lay your tape measure right over the copper pipe and measure from one side to the other. Then you can take that measurement and go to our website, where we list all of the copper tube sizes for escutcheons in OD. So if you have half-inch pipe, you're going to need a 5/8 inch OD escutcheon. Galvanized is a little trickier, because galvanized is measured by the inside diameter, and we call that IPS, iron pipe size inside diameter. What you're going to want to do is lay your tape measure over the pipe, but you're also going to have to do a little bit of guesswork, because the outside diameter is not the same as what you're going to need for your escutcheon. It's kind of a guesstimate. So like, this is half inch pipe, so it's around 3/4 when I measure it this way. We do have a chart on our website that will let you convert whatever measurement you got into the correct iron pipe size. And then you can take that and find the escutcheon size you need. Now, some of you may be asking yourselves at this point, well, can I just measure my old escutcheon and buy the same size as that one? And if you have copper pipe, yes, you can, because you can measure the inside diameter of this little hole right here, and it will match whatever we say the OD of the pipe is. If you have galvanized, however, that's not going to be so easy, because again, even if you measure the inside diameter of this escutcheon, you still have to know what the inside diameter of the pipe is, because we don't, for IPS, list the outside diameter of the pipe because it changes. So either way, for IPS, you're still going to need to measure and then go to the conversion chart on our website to find out what the actual pipe size is before you purchase your escutcheons. We hope that this has helped you figure out what size escutcheon you need for your application. But as always, if you can't figure it out or you just need extra help, please feel free to contact us at PlumbingSupply.com, and our team of exceptional customer service representatives will be more than happy to help you. I'm Carolyn from PlumbingSupply.com. Thanks for watching.